Hey guys, what's up? It's Mac. So my top surgery is in 1 week. I'm still collecting donations and funds for my top surgery as my final payment is not due until my day of surgery. So if you guys happen to want to donate or share my page, my You Caring link is in the description. I love you guys. So today, I just wanted to talk about my hopes and fears of top surgery. For those of you who didn't know, I'm gonna be having top surgery with Dr. Medalli, who is in Cleveland, Ohio. I'll be traveling to see him. So I'll start with my fears. So the one thing, well, one of the things that I'm really kind of anxious about is I still don't know what kind of surgery I'll be getting. There are two possibilities. One is periareolar, which is where they just go around the nipple and they take out all the things, they sew it up, and you won't really have any scars. So the pros of that is you won't have any scars. The cons of periareolar are that your nipples are gonna be a little bit lower than where most cisgender males' nipples are, and your areola will be shrinked. He resizes it. But your nipple, most of the time, he's not able to resize it the first surgery. So you're gonna end up with a smaller areola, but your nipple's gonna be kinda big, which is not pleasant. So normally you have to go back in for a revision, and he'll just go in the office and, fix it quickly. But most of the time your blood flow isn't good enough for him to do the revision of your nipple right then and there. So the other kind of procedure I could possibly be getting is double incision. And double incision is where they make two slits and they take out all the stuff and then they take your nipples and they graft them. They resize them and they graft them higher up to where most cisgender males' nipples are. And then they sew it up. So the cons of double incision are you're gonna have two big scars. The pros are you're gonna have better nipple placement and you won't really most likely have to go in for a revision. So I still don't know what kind of surgery I'll be getting because my chest is kind of the size in between. You get periareolar if you're about an A cup chest size, and if you're bigger than that, you typically go for double incision, and I'm kind of right in the middle. So I'm a little bit angsty, I don't really know what's gonna happen. I will be 100% fine either way, because I just want these things off of me and thrown in a frickin' dumpster. So I'm not actually nervous about pain or people cutting into me. I'm not really nervous about that. The things that I'm nervous about are kind of things that would be after the surgery. So let me list those for you. I've heard that you can get nauseous after surgery, and I hate being nauseous. I've only thrown up a handful of times in my life, and I hate it. I'm sure as most people do, but I really hate it. And so I'm worried about being nauseous after surgery. I'm really, really worried. So I hate crying. I think it's the absolute worst. I don't like it at all. And a lot of times after you come out of anesthesia, a good amount of people wake up crying, and it's really weird. And when I had my wisdom teeth out when I was 18, I woke up crying and I was super embarrassed about it, and that would be terrible, and I really don't want that to happen. I'm also really nervous about bloating. Most people after top surgery, your stomach is going out. So if you see me in videos after surgery and I'm really bloated, it's not because I've gained a lot of weight, it's because I'm just really bloated from anesthesia and the surgery. And the last thing that I'm kind of nervous about is the drains that come out are right under your armpits, and I hate things touching my armpits. If shirts are too tight and they're touching my armpits, that's so uncomfortable to me. And so I'm really not looking forward to drains coming out of my armpits. So my hopes about top surgery are kind of, just the opposite of everything that I just said. But just that I'm not too uncomfortable and I'm not in too much pain. And the main thing is that I just want to come out with a result that I'm in love with, which I'm sure I will. Dr. Medalli is a great surgeon. I'm hoping for no complications with surgery afterwards. Sometimes there's like, people can get like, I think they're called hematomas, is that what it's called? Correct me if I'm wrong, but like, you know, like big swelling and bumps, which go away. So yeah, anyways, 1 week until top surgery. These are just some of my hopes and fears, and I'm so excited. Please wish me luck, and if you are so willing as to send me some good healing vibes and energy, that would be phenomenal. I would really, really love you forever. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and comment down below. Share this video and my channel with your friends, and if you haven't followed me on social media, what are you doing? The links are in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.